see them?
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
So when we start defining nocturia, it has been defined as the need for an individual to wake up one or more times during the night to avoid urine, and it affects any age, and there are multiple factors. The prevalence of nocturia varies markedly depending on the definition and age group surveyed. In general, the prevalence of nocturia increases with the age, ranging from 4% in children aged 7 to 15 years to approximately 70% in adults aged more than 60 years. So it will be difficult to conclude that nocturia is a normal part of aging because it is not universally present in all the older adults, as I have already told you. Now, what nocturia causes actually, it is the main renal defense against the surge of blood pressure. So when we talk of nocturia and blood pressure, it is a defensive mechanism. And symptom of uncontrolled hypertension, which is very, very important. So not only hypertension, diabetes as well, the another metabolic disease. So if any patient presents to us with nocturia, we should take it seriously, looking after the uncontrolled hypertension and also the diabetic status of the patient. The hypertension induces natriuresis with diuresis. That is, the pressure natriuresis relationship is there, and this reset in hypertension causing higher urine output at night than during the daytime, and this is the nocturnal polyuria. The pathogenesis is complex and sometimes multifactorial, involving several organ systems of the body, abnormally increased urine production, decreased bladder storage capacity, or disturbed sleep pattern leading to waking at night. So nocturia again is a very important symptom of chronic kidney disease. That is the inability to concentrate urine. The causes we can enumerate like the prostatic disease, urinary tract infection, diabetes, as I have told you, sleep apnea, salt retaining, edema forming states like the venous insufficiency, heart failure, and the kidney failure. Uncontrolled hypertension, resistant hypertension, diuretics, calcium channel blockers, nitrodipine, autonomic neuropathy, Parkinsonism. So any patient coming to us with nocturia, we have to look for what medicine the patient is taking. Are any of these medicines causing this nocturia? And second thing is that long-standing diabetes mellitus, patient having autonomic neuropathy, we have to look for this cause. There is compulsive water drinking at night. We Indians, we get up at night, go for urination. Again, we come, have a glass or half of water. Again, this vicious cycle goes in, and water in the Cooper vessel wash out toxic elements. 3 a.m. sometimes during the REM sleep also. And then there is sleep deprivation because of nocturia. The various drugs causing nocturia are metoprolol, which is a lipid soluble, which crosses blood-brain barrier. There are at times dreams, there are arousals, and then nocturia. Calcium channel blocker, nitrodipine, only calcium channel blocker having persistent natriuretic effect, and that causes nocturia. Then diuretics, decongestant like phenylephrine, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, lithium, theophylline, and corticosteroids. So before investigating, before we have to take a good history of drug intake by the patient, what medicine the patient is taking. Usually in adults, there is polypharmacy. So in elderly, there are changes in the kidney sodium handling, water conserving mechanisms, circadian rhythm, GFR, and the impaired responsiveness to the AVP. So these are the various causes we have to look for in the elderly as well. The consequences of aging are very several: increased prevalence of sleep disorder, breathing, and the sleep apnea. The chief symptom is nocturia in such cases, and it is not snoring. Cardiometabolic neurologic consequences of sleep disorder, breathing, hypertension with nocturia, sleep apnea is another very important combination. Now in non-dippers, Dr. Agrawal and colleagues have noted association of nocturia with non-dipping and effects on the hypertension. And we can see here the components of the nocturnal hypertension and determinants, nighttime dipping status and surge in blood pressure, which we can very well see in this depicted picture. So nocturia, that is the repeated arousals and rise in blood pressure, they are vicious cycle. CKD increases risk of OSA, while OSA hastens the progression of CKD, so again there is a vicious cycle with CKD and nocturia. 50 to 70% of end-stage renal diseases have obstructive sleep apnea, and CKD, obstructive sleep apnea, and hypertension, they said many risk factors together, and this is a complex triad. Now, the worsening of chronic kidney disease and worsening of obstructive sleep apnea and hypertension, again, this is a vicious cycle. The OSA stimulates ANP secretion through hypoxic induced vasoconstrictive, causing increased right atrial pressure. And the studies have shown that this increase in the frequency of nocturia in OSA patients, as well as positive correlation between severity of OSA and frequency of nocturnal urination, has been detailed. The OSA ANP, there is actual natriuretic peptide which causes natriuresis, and that causes the prevention of hypertension. And the mechanism is through the increased transmural pressure due to the pulmonary constriction as a result of hypoxia, plus the increased venous returns. If you look into this, there is onset of sleep. What happens? There is a collapse of the soft upper airway structure, which produces obstructive apnea. And also there is continued respiratory effort through the negative pressure breathing, and they lead to vagal bradycardia plus systemic and pulmonary vasoconstriction, tachycardia, sympathetic stimulation, central hypervolemia, false signal of fluid overload, again leading to atria, produces ANP. There is natriuresis leading to nocturia. On the other side, if you look at the collapse of soft upper airway structure, which produces obstructive apnea, there is hypoxia, hypercapnia, and acidosis. And through the chemoreceptor trigger and spontaneous arousal, again there is tachycardia and sympathetic stimulation. This also leads to return of the airway muscle tone, relief of airway obstruction, and apnea. The salt sensitivity having effect on the circulating volume. We are supine during the sleep because of the increased vascular damage. Nocturnal hypertension is there, and the nocturnal increase in the circulating volume. Nighttime risk during the sleep, we can see that through the baroreceptor reflexes, which decrease, there is nighttime BP surge, and which triggers the stroke and myocardial infarction, vascular dementia in these patients. Because of the increased LV afterload, increased LV wall stress, there is heart failure. And if you look on the right side, because of the intraglomerular pressure increase, hyperfiltration, there is kidney injury. So the obstructive sleep apnea cause for resistant hypertension, proteinuria, OSA, which is resistant hypertension, and CKD have common pathogenic associations, volume overload, excessive RAS activation, hyperaldosteronism, endothelial-derived vasoconstriction, inflammation, increased reactive oxygen markers, and the proteinuria. And as a consequence of nocturia, which results in the fragmented sleep, short and fragmented sleep has been associated with poor sleep quality, fatigue, daytime sleepiness, impaired daytime performance, and increased risk of cardiovascular disease events and the premature death. And at times, there is patients have a fall in the bathroom as well. So we can say that it is a sangam where hypertension, nocturia, and obstructive sleep apnea, and obstructive sleep apnea often is not detected. As I have already mentioned, that it may not be the snoring, it may simply be a poorly urinuria symptom, and we have to investigate for OSA as well. Now, what we have to do is that target the morning hypertension, the morning blood pressure, home BP should be less than 130/80. Then target the masked uncontrolled nocturnal hypertension, which is very, very important, because there is circulating volume is increased, there is vascular disease, OSA, and increased sympathetic activity and insomnia, and they all lead to nighttime increase in the blood pressure, and which is the perfect cardiovascular risk reduction. If you look at these four important factors, the nighttime blood pressure will be less than 110/60, basal BP will decrease, the BP surge will also decrease, and it will reduce the risk of cardiovascular problems. The pelvic floor muscles, exercise to increase tone of the pelvic floor muscle, help to overcome the nocturia, and there are the Kegel exercises as well. So nocturia, preventing nocturia saves water for washing hands during corona times. But the another important thing is that, yes, we have to investigate nocturia, what are the causes, and treat nocturia, just not overlook. Thank you very much. I thank the chairpersons for giving me this opportunity to present before them. So thank you very much.